In this video, we will discuss about Imogen King's goal attainment theory. Coming to the introduction to theorist, she was born on January 30, 1923, and she had attained her nursing diploma in 1945 from St. John's Hospital of Nursing. In 1948, she attained B.S. Nursing and Education with a minors in Philosophy and Chemistry from St. Louis University. 1957, attained her M.S. Nursing from St. John's University, and in 1980 she attained an honorary Ph.D. from Southern Linnaeus University, and she had done a postdoctoral study in research design, statistics and computer. Died on December 24, 2007 after suffering from stroke. Coming to the model, she developed an open system framework for her theory. The theory describes a dynamic interpersonal relationship in which a person grows and develops to attain certain life goals. And there are some factors which affect the attainment of goal are role, stress, space and time. So this open system is based on the assumption that humans are open systems in constant interaction with their environment. And this consists of three interacting systems like personal, interpersonal and social systems. This is the conceptual model of the King's goal attainment theory. So here she tells about the person's open system consisting of personal system, interpersonal system and social systems. So, coming to the three systems of conceptual framework, as I already said, the personal system, it is the individual. Interpersonal system, when the individual is interacting with one another. Social system occurs when a group of people in a community or society sharing a common goal or sharing a common interest and values, that consisting of a social system. So, systems are whole rather than it is isolated part of a open system. So we are studying this in this goal attainment theory, this system as a whole. Coming to the personal system concept, it consists of solely the individual, and it is having some factors like perception, self, growth and development, body image, space, time, learning, etc. So we'll see each one in detail. Perception, it is the influence of, it influences all other behavior. Perception means a person's representation of reality. Reality as seen by an individual. So it is the organizing, interpreting and transforming information. And perception is universal and it is highly subjective and unique to each person. Second, next is self. It is the awareness of being a person separate from others. A person's subjective environment which constitute everything that makes up the person, that includes the ideas of a person, attitudes, values and commitment of a person. So each person will be unique from another being. Next is growth and development. All the changes, that it can be the cellular or molecular or behavior changes which is occurring in a person during the life process, is the growth and development. So these changes are usually orderly in manner and it is predictable, and there can be some individual variations can occur in growth and development. And it moves a person from potential to achievement. Then next is body image. Body image refers to the manner in which one perceives one's own body and the reaction of others to it. And it is a body image, it is very personal and subjective. It can be acquired or learned, and it is dynamic and changing. Next is space. The immediate physical territory occupied by a person and to the person's behavior is considered as space in this model. And this exists in every direction and is the same in all directions. It includes that physical area that is named as territory, and it is defined by a person's behavior. Next is time. Time is an interval between two events that is experienced differently by each person. A sequence of events and their relationship to each other will be influenced by time. Next is learning. She says about learning, but she is not defined what learning actually interprets in the theory. Next is the interpersonal system concept. Interpersonal system occurs when human actualize and includes this interpersonal system includes interaction, communication, transaction, role and stress. So when there is greater number of interacting individuals, the more the complex of more complex the interaction will be. So when two persons are interacting, that is called as dyad. Three persons are interacting, that is triad. And when there is four or more people are there in the interaction, that is known as small or large group according to the number. So coming to the first one, the first concept of interpersonal system is interaction. Interaction is the process of perception and communication between person and environment and between person and person. So perception and communication between the person and environment, or it may be the perception and communication between two people, a person and another person. And it is represented by verbal or non-verbal behavior that seek to reach the goal. It can be, interaction can be verbal interaction, or it can be normal non-verbal interaction. But the main ultimate aim is to reach the or achieve the goal. Next is communication. Communication is the exchange of information between people. That can be in many methods, like face-to-face communication can be there, or it can be electronic media, or we can use a written communication. And this communication may be intrapersonal or interpersonal communication can happen. So information is the component of this interaction. Next is transaction. Next component of interpersonal system is transaction. The process of interaction in which human beings communicate with the environment to achieve goal or value. And these interactions are goal-directed human behaviors, and the mutual goal setting is occurring in transaction. So when two persons are interacting with one another, there will be mutual goal setting. That is called as transaction. And in the transaction phase, the mutual goal setting is attained. Next is role. Role means it is a set of expected behavior. And this role or the expected behavior is based on the position, the rights and responsibilities of an individual, relationship between the individuals. So these all factors will influence the expected behavior. Next is stress. Stress is occurring when there is an ever-changing condition where an individual interacts with the environment to maintain the balance for growth, development and performance. It is the exchange of information or energy. It can be negative or positive, and it between the human and environment for regulation and control of stresses. Next is coping. Coping is considered very important in King's theory, but it is not defined by King. The last one is social system concept. Social system is when interpersonal system comes together, they form larger systems like social system. For example, it can be family, religious group, workplace and peer group. These all are examples for social system. And this social system comprises social roles, behavior, practices, and they are developed to maintain the values in the particular social system. So the concepts of social systems are organization, authority, power, status and decision making. So we will move on in detail with the social system concept. First one is organization. Organization means a group of people with similar interests who have prescribed roles and positions and who use resources to achieve personal and organizational goals. So this organizational concept consisting of four parameters: human values, behavior patterns, needs, goals and expectations, natural environment which containing essential materials and resources. It contains individuals who form groups and interact for goal achievement. And also the last parameter is technology to facilitate the goal attainment. The next is authority. It refers to the observable behavior for providing guidance and order and being responsible for action. the authority can is very active, it can, and it can be reciprocal also. Next is power. Power is a situational, dynamical and goal-oriented concept, and it is characterized by the ability to use resources for goal achievement. And power is also mean by power is also by which one or a person can influence the other. Next is the status. It refers to the position occupied by a person in a group in relation to other groups in an organization. That is a status. Next is decision making. Decision making results from developing and acting on a perceived choices of goal attainment. So coming to the goal, so these are the concepts of each system, and coming to the goal attainment theory. Goal attainment theory represents an expansion of King's original ideas to incorporate the concept of the nurse and the patient when they are mutually communicating the information, establishing goals and taking action to achieve the goal. It describes a situation in which two people, usually they are strangers, they come together in a healthcare organization to help or to be helped to maintain a state of health. And this theory is based on the concept of the personal and interpersonal system, which includes interaction, perception, communication, transaction, role, stress, growth and development, time and space. This is a schematic representation of goal attainment theory. Here, the perception and communication of the nurse and the perception and communication of the client interact together. When they come and interact together, there will be transaction will be occurring, and there will be mutual goal setting will be occurring, and they both will be exploring each other, or they both agreeing to each other to achieve the mutual goal set by them. Next is the assumptions of the theory. The main assumptions of this goal attainment theory is the focus of nursing is the care of human being or the patient. The goal of nursing is the healthcare of both individual and groups. Human beings are open systems. They are interacting with their environment constantly. The nurse and the patient communicate information, set goals mutually, and then act to achieve these goals. Next assumption is patient achieves the world as a complete person, making transactions with individuals and things in the environment. Again, assumption is King is transaction represents a life situation in which the perceiver and the thing being perceived are encountered. It is also represents a life situation in which a person enters the situation as an active participant, and each is changed in the process of this experience. Coming to the meta paradigm in the King's goal attainment theory, there are four meta paradigms, as like in any other theory, like person, environment, health and nursing. So coming to the first one, person. Person or human being refers to a social being who are rational and sentient, and she says that person has the ability to perceive, think, feel, choose, set goals, select means to achieve goals and to make decision. And persons have the ability to communicate their thoughts, action, customs and beliefs through language, and they exhibit common characteristics like ability to perceive, think, feel, choose between the alternative courses of action, set goals and to make decision. And according to King, she says that there are mainly three fundamental needs in a human being. The first one is the need for health information, and the second is need for health care that seek to prevent illness, and the last one is need for care when human beings are unable to help themselves. Next is health. She says that health is a dynamic life experience of a human being, and health implies continuous adjustment to stressors in the external and internal environment through optimum use of one's resources to achieve maximum potential for daily living. Coming to the next one, environment. Environment, she says that environment is the background of human actions and it consisting of internal and external environment. Internal environment transforms energy to enable person to adjust to continuous external environmental changes, and external environment involves formal and informal organization. And here in this theory, nursing is a part of a patient's environment. Coming to the next one, nursing. She says that nursing is a process of action, reaction and interaction whereby nurse and the client share information about their perceptions in the nursing situation. Here the nurse and the patient share goals, problems and concerns and explore means to achieve the particular goal. She defines the goal of nurse. She says that goal of nurse is to help the individual to maintain their health so they can function in their roles. And she also defines the domain of nurse. She says it includes the promoting, maintaining and restoring health and caring for the sick, injured and dying. And lastly, she says function of professional nurse, that is to interpret the information in a nursing process to plan, implement and evaluate the nursing care. Coming to the strength and weakness of the theory. Strength of the theory, it is very easy to understand and it describes the logical sequence of events and the concepts are concretely defined and illustrated in this theory. Coming to the weakness, the theory is having some limited application in the areas of nursing and it lacks application in groups, families or communities, and it is concentrated in didactic relation, that is the relationship between the two persons. Thank you.